blows the horn here, and I'm blowing the horn as loudly as I can to let people know what time it is, so they know what they ought to be doing. The calamities shall come upon Babylon. Her plagues shall be many. Flee Babylon. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much. The warning came to Babylon with the destruction of the two towers. Jehovah was saying to Babylon, change your ways. However, Babylon responded in defiance. We remember, we rebuild, we come back stronger. So now her plagues shall come upon her. Flee Babylon. You see, because Babylon is one of the four horns, and the four horns want to scatter Judah, Jerusalem, and Israel. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee, and thy seed after thee in their generations for an everlasting covenant, to be a God unto thee and to thy seed after thee. And I will give unto thee and to thy seed after thee the land wherein thou art a stranger, all the land of Canaan, for an everlasting possession, and I will be their God. Genesis 17, verses 7 and 8. Then I raised my eyes and looked, and there were four horns. And I said to the angel who talked with me, what are these? So he answered me, these are the horns that have scattered Judah, Israel, and Jerusalem. Zechariah 1, verses 18 and 19. The four horns, the quartet. The quartet, set up in 2002, consists of the United Nations, the European Union, the United States, and Russia. Its mandate is to help mediate Middle East peace negotiations and to support Palestinian economic development and institution building in preparation for eventual statehood. The quartet, the United Nations, the European Union, the Russian Federation, and the United States. So, the very purpose of the quartet is to divide the land of Israel, to create a Palestinian state, and to divide Jerusalem, with East Jerusalem being the capital of a future Palestinian state, which is similar to the Abraham Accord, the vision of peace, in inverted commas, the one that was brought by the rider on the white horse, the covenant with many. And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder, and one of the four beasts saying, come and see. And I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, a covenant, and a crown was given unto him. He was elected president, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. I'm taking on China. Revelation 6, verses 1 and 2. A vision of peace the carving out of Judea and Samaria, the very heart of Israel, and the dividing of Jerusalem. The covenant with many. And an angel of the Lord came up from Gilgal to Bochim and said, I made you to go up out of Egypt and have brought you unto the land which I swear unto your fathers. And I said, I will never break my covenant with you. Judges 2 verse 1. And ye shall make no league covenant with the inhabitants of this land. Ye shall throw down their altars. But ye have not obeyed my voice. Why have you done this? Wherefore I also said, I will not drive them out from before you, but they shall be as thorns in your sides, and their gods shall be a snare unto you. Judges 2, verses 2 and 3. And it came to pass, when the angel of the Lord spake these words unto all the children of Israel, that the people lifted up their voice and wept. Judges 2, verse 4. This is how the Lord feels about Israel entering into a covenant with the many. And as a sign of his displeasure, the Lord brought this. Which, in turn, led to this. Gantz. Dropping sovereignty paved way for Abraham Accords. And now, they are admitting that they gave up Judea and Samaria for this covenant of peace, this vision of peace, this covenant with many. That is why the Lord is not pleased. October 12th, 2021. An event to advance the implementation, to advance and implement the Abraham Accords. 1 year anniversary of the Abraham Accords. So, according to Gantz, the fact that we prevented a unilateral move of annexation allowed the vision of the Abraham Accords to materialize and break through. I am very happy that these peace treaties were signed, and I am sure they will be expanded and be an engine of change in the Middle East, Gantz said. The covenant with many, giving up Judea and Samaria, the dropping of the apple of God's eye. Knesset launches Abraham Accord caucus with Gantz claiming credit for deals. Lapid, Gantz say new government seeks peace with Palestinians and other Arab states. Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump attend and meet with Netanyahu, won't be meeting Bennett. 11th of October 2021. Judgment is coming to the entire earth, because the quartet is pretty much made up of the whole world, the United Nations, the European Union, the Russian Federation, and the United States. So, after the rider on the white horse brought this covenant, War is the next thing. After the initial calamities, the first calamity was C-19, which led to the beginning of the economic collapse, the Black Horse, which will lead us up to the Red Horse, which will make the economic collapse even worse and bring lots and lots of death. And of course, Zechariah 1 verses 18 to 21 speaks of the four craftsmen who have come to sand down the four horns, who stand in pride, who wish to scatter Jerusalem, Judah, Jerusalem, and Israel. Speak to Zerubbabel, governor of Judah, saying, I will shake heavens and earth. I will overthrow the throne of kingdoms. I will destroy the strength of the Gentile kingdoms. I will overthrow the chariots and those who ride in them. The horses and their riders shall come down, everyone by the sword of his brother. Haggai 2 verses 21 to 22. This is what the Lord is about to do. He is about to overthrow the nations. This is the end, or the beginning of the end of the Gentile nations, starting with C-19 and the resulting economic fallout, which will lead us to the Red Horse of War. Funny enough, it seems these will start with the nations round about Israel, who incidentally mostly have the colors white, red, black, and green. Is this an indication of where the troubles will begin? As we see in Lebanon, Yemen, and Afghanistan, famine and war and discontent. But Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me, and my Lord has forgotten me. Can a woman forget her nursing child? The Lord asks, and not have compassion on the son of her womb? Surely they may forget, yet I will not forget you. See, I have inscribed you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are continually before me. Isaiah 49, verses 14 to 16. This is Jerusalem, Zion, asking if she had been forgotten. You see, Zion's children were given up as a ransom, taken to the land of the enemy, and they are still there. And that is what Zion is crying out for, her children. And the Lord is comforting Zion, because the Lord will redeem her children and bring them back into her borders. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, he sent me after glory to the nations which plunder you, for he who touches you touches the apple of his eye. For surely I will shake my hand against them, and they shall become spoil for their servants. Then you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me. Zechariah 2 verses 8 and 9. For he that touches you touches the apple, the pupil of his eye. That is why he's coming against the Gentile nations. It's time to regather. It's time for the great Aliyah. because they have broken the everlasting covenant, given up Judea and Samaria for peace, for the covenant with many, the covenant with death. Behold, the Lord maketh the earth empty, and maketh it waste, and turneth it upside down, and scattereth abroad the inhabitants thereof. And it shall be as with the people, so with the priest, as with the servant, so with his master, as with the maid, so with her mistress, as with the buyer, so with the seller, as with the lender, so with the borrower, as with the taker of usury, so with the giver of usury to him. Isaiah 24 verses 1 and 2. The land shall be utterly emptied and utterly spoiled, for the Lord has spoken this word. The earth mourneth and fadeth away, the world languisheth and fadeth away, the haughty people of the earth do languish. Isaiah 24 verse 3 to 4. The earth also is defiled under the inhabitants thereof, because they have transgressed the laws, changed the ordinance, broken the everlasting covenant. Therefore hath the curse devoured the earth, and they that dwell therein are desolate. Therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burnt, and few men left. Isaiah 24, verses 5 and 6. This is the reason why the troubles have come upon the earth. It's the final straw that broke the camel's back. The covenant with many. The covenant with death. That is why the Gentile nations are about to be judged. And where is the headquarters of the Gentile nations? Well, it's in New York, the symbol of Babylon. Remember this? Remember our timeline? Trump being the reason for judgment. The Abraham Accords, the covenant with many. That is the reason why the judgments have come and will come. As we have been told, 2017 Economist cover, 2019 Economist cover, Four Horsemen. Artemisia Gentishili. Take the milestones and grind meal, uncover thy locks, make bare the legs, uncover the thigh, pass over the rivers, thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. Isaiah 47 verses 2 and 3. This speaks of Artemisia Gentishili, the Gentile nations, which find ultimate expression in Babylon, New York. The Lord will take vengeance upon New York. He will bring calamities upon her. And one of the calamities coming is etched in the pillars in front of this particular cathedral. Cathedral of St. John the Divine, which is in New York. And in front of this cathedral, you have different depictions. One depicting waves of water coming over the city. One depicting a great earthquake. Another one depicting the birth of this figure, which I can only assume symbolizes the birthing of the Antichrist, which happens after the calamities, the fire, the chaos, out of which rises the phoenix. And then, of course, the last one just depicts death and destruction. This is the calamity that we are particularly interested in. Waves have come over the city. Funny, it's called the Cathedral of St. John the Divine. Because whoever built it was divining. Practicing sorcery. As is depicted in this scene in iPad Goat, which basically alludes to the partial lunar eclipse, which is coming up on the 19th of November. Could this be a harbinger of calamities to come to Babylon, USA? And the solar eclipse on the 4th of December. Could these be harbingers of things to come? Because then we come to this scene where we've got water all around the Statue of Liberty, and we have the lights going out above her. And as the lights go out, the torch falls, or is broken off, and falls to the ground. This is speaking of a calamity coming upon New York. The sea is come upon Babylon. She is covered with the multitude of the waves thereof. Her cities are a desolation, a dry land, and a wilderness, a land wherein no man dwelleth, neither doth any son of man pass thereby. Jeremiah 51, verses 42-43. And I will punish Bel in Babylon, and I will bring forth out of his mouth that which he hath swallowed up, and the nations shall not flow together any more unto him. Yea, the wall of Babylon shall fall. Jeremiah 5:51-44. My people, go ye out of the midst of her, and deliver ye every man his soul from the fierce anger of the Lord, and let your heart faint, and ye fear for the rumour that shall be heard in the land. A rumour shall both come one year, and after that in another year shall come a rumour and violence in the land, ruler against ruler. Jeremiah 51 verses 45-46. Could this be speaking of the outbreak of civil war after this calamity of a tsunami? Up, up, flee from the land of the north, says the Lord, for I have spread you abroad like the four winds of heaven, says the Lord. Up, Zion, escape, you who dwell with the daughter of Babylon. Zechariah 2 verses 6 to 7. Babylon, the mother of exile. But his father refused and said, I know, my son, I know. He also shall become a people, and he also shall be great. But truly, his younger brother shall be greater than he, and his descendants shall become a multitude of nations, peoples, goyim. Genesis 48, verse 19. Ephraim mixes herself with the Gentile nations, seeking favor with one country, then another. Ephraim is a cake not turned, worthless, ready to be thrown away. Strangers have devoured his strength, yet he does not know it. Gray hairs are sprinkled on him, yet he does not know. Hosea 7 verses 8 to 9. Ephraim, USA. It harbors the greatest number of Jews outside of Israel. So, the Exodus can only begin in earnest when Babylon falls. Flee Babylon. It is time to make Aliyah. Before this calamity hits, it is time to make Teshuvah and to return. The Lord is about to judge the Gentile nations. And it's interesting that at this very time, dozens of cargo ships stuck waiting off New York's coast amidst surging demand for goods, a report says. Dozens of container ships appear to be stuck waiting off the coast of New York, per Mail Online. Supply chain issues are affecting many countries. So, outside New York, the ships. Could this be the reason why shipmasters are reacting? At the fall of Babylon. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. Revelation 18 verse 4. For her sins have reached unto heaven, and God hath remembered her iniquity. Reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her, double according to her works, in the cup which she hath filled. Fill to her double. Revelation 18 verses 5 and 6. How much she hath glorified herself and lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow give her. For she saith in her heart, I sit a queen, and am no widow, and shall see no sorrow. Revelation 18 verse 7. Therefore shall her plagues come in one day, death and mourning and famine, and she shall be utterly burned with fire. For strong is the Lord God, who judgeth her. Revelation 18 verse 8. And the merchants of the earth shall weep and mourn over her, for no man buyeth their merchandise any more. The merchants of these things which were made rich by her, she shall stand afar off for the fear of her torment, weeping and wailing. Revelation 18 verses 11 and 15. And saying, alas, alas, that great city that was clothed in fine linen, purple and scarlet, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls. for in 1 hour so great riches is come to naught. And every shipmaster and all the company in ships and sailors and as many as trade by sea stood afar off. Revelation 18 verses 16 and 17, and cried when they saw the smoke of her burning, saying, what city is like unto this great city? And they cast dust on their heads and cried, weeping and wailing, saying, alas, alas, that great city wherein were made rich all that had ships in the sea by reason of her costliness. For in 1 hour is she made desolate. Revelation 18 verses 18 to 19. And what could be the cause of this desolation? As we can see, one of the drawings on this 2019 Economist cover, a volcano. Interesting. Combra Vieja? How could they have known? Combra Vieja. And what is causing this? Well, it's the approach of the fiery red dragon. Combra Vieja. Depicted in IPETCO 2. The eruption that made ripples in the sky. Thermal blasts from La Palma volcano can be seen in the clouds. 6th of October, 2021. Just so we can be sure that what was depicted in IPETCO 2 is an actual fact, this particular volcanic eruption. Spain's La Palma volcano eruption has created rare phenomena of concentric ripple clouds above the island. Natural sites was caused by thermal inversions as the volcanic air was forced sideways after meeting warm air. The concentric ripples off the island of Tenerife, otherwise known as the Canary Islands, which is home to Combra Vieja. Tenerife tsunami warning, catastrophic volcano eruption could devastate Canary Islands. Scientists have warned that a volcanic eruption in Tenerife could trigger a tsunami that could cause catastrophic effects. 8th of October, 2021. I want you to take note of the board to the left of this character with the pins. Take note of the pins. Note that there's one in New York, one over the Gulf of Mexico, one Louisiana. And one over Oklahoma. Perhaps this is letting us know that something big is about to hit.
Good morning. I had a dream about a tsunami on the east coast of the United States. Before I get into that dream, I'm going to link below the video that I did 2 years almost exactly to when La Palma started erupting. I had a dream, I believe, from the Lord about the end of the world. There were two volcanic eruptions, and one was a volcano that's West Bank collapsed into the sea. Okay, so I'm linking that below. Feel free to watch that. But I have this kind of moment of, okay, does that mean I know when or if a tsunami is going to come? Absolutely not. But here was the dream I was given. I was in the Outer Banks, which is the coast of North Carolina, with my dad's side of the family. That's where we always vacationed, at the beach. And we're in a beach house. My six-year-old daughter is behind me coming down some stairs. In front of me is a large table. That's a kitchen table and a big picture window. People are sitting and eating. I thought it was breakfast, but I'm not entirely sure. And my four-year-old was at the table looking out the picture window. Out of nowhere, all we can see is a huge, huge wave. And we had no warning. By the time we saw the wave, there was no time. It was about to hit the house, and we were on beachfront. The wave hits the house, and it's almost like there's a chapter turn there, because I didn't see the house collapse. I didn't have to get out of the rubble. I simply was working hard to gather my littlest first, my four-year-old, and then find my six-year-old, and we are in the water. I don't remember debris floating around us. I remember being in the water and struggling to keep us all afloat. I directed them to grab onto my back. Neither of them can swim. I had them both grabbing onto my back, one onto another, and instructing them to hold tight. I was raised in the ocean as a water rat, just swimming through the waves, getting tumbled by all the waves. I know how to manage myself in the surf. I'm facing the land. So the ocean would be to my back in this deep water. And what I'm experiencing is waves coming back. So even though I'm facing inland, there are waves rolling back toward me, like surf. And I am navigating them with my children, trying to keep us all afloat. I remember I was struggling hard. I was not frightened in the dream, but I was very focused on keeping us above water. I know which waves we can crest because they're not breaking. I know which waves were huge and breaking and we need to dive under. Thinking about it now is, I think awake, I was more troubled by what I saw in the dream than I was in the dream. I was simply focused. And I remember every time we had to dive under, I told them to hold on tight, and I was struggling to push them back above the surface. And any parent who's ever been in a situation with children in water can just say that is just one of the most terrifying things. There's only so much that you can do. And I remember my daughter screaming underwater. Like I said, I don't remember. I don't remember being frightened in the dream, but certainly awake, it has me thinking. North Carolina is an area of the East Coast of the United States that is not protected. Where I live, I am protected by the Eastern Shore. The Eastern Shore, if something came across, would take the first brunt, and then there would be lots of flooding to where I'm living. But I want to call the saints to pray, because I believe a tsunami on the East Coast of the United States is part two to what I saw 2 years ago. And how soon? I don't know. I mean, that the dream about the volcanoes was 2 years ago. I include in that volcanic dream that the world was sectioned off. There was lots of flooding. The world was sectioned off, that people could not cross from one country to another. You were not allowed to cross borders. And there was a lot of violence in China. Please pray, especially for those on the East Coast that might be affected by this. Lord, we just ask that you would give anyone who is in the path of something destructive that might be coming, give them warning, Lord. Give them time to get out. Make them restless in their sleep. Plan a vacation for them in another area of the country. We ask your protection over people, over parents, over children, over elderly, over people that are not going to be able to survive a disaster like this. God, would you remove them from those places? Would you give them time to evacuate? Would you give them fair warning in Jesus' name? Would you make them troubled in their spirits? Would you give us warning, Lord? And we also pray against the tsunami. If this is something that can be stopped, we pray against it in Jesus' name, that there would not be a collapse of that volcano, that it would not cause a tsunami on the East Coast, knowing, God, that you are sovereign and that this broken world is in the palm of your hands. And we thank you, Lord, and we commend our own lives into your spirit, that we love not our own life unto death. And may you give us direction and guidance, that we may be a help and a joy and a light among darkness. We pray for the people that are being affected directly by the volcano, those who've lost their homes, their lives, their loved ones, their possessions, those who are being rehomed and evacuated. We lift them up to you now in Jesus' name. Amen. That's it. That is my first ever tsunami dream. I've never seen one before. And I was in it. So if any of you have had similar confirmations, please let me know. Jeremiah 51 was a place that I went to in the scripture. I have not found scripture to support what I saw necessarily. That makes sense. Jeremiah has to do with the waves coming over Babylon. It's judgment of Babylon. but other than that, everyone be in prayer.
This is La Palma, one of the Canary Islands, a paradise for sun-loving tourists. For us, the island holds quite another fascination, the Cumbre Vieja volcano. The brittle western slope of the volcano is covered in clefts and fissures where water has collected. And now for the interesting part. By placing several bombs in carefully calculated spots, we can use thermonuclear explosions to heat that water so that it will evaporate instantaneously. If you had paid attention in your physics classes, you would know that such a sudden evaporation of water would create sufficient pressure to shatter the volcano's brittle slope and send it crashing into the sea. Can you guess what comes next? That's right, a tsunami. Waves 200 meters high will charge across the Atlantic with the speed of an airplane. The tsunami will sweep across the east coast of the United States. New York will disappear in an apocalyptic flood, taking with it the self-proclaimed rulers of the world who are currently squabbling in blind incompetence at the UN headquarters. The resulting vacuum of power will be filled by our followers, some of whom have been biding their time in key positions for decades. They will take control and lead humankind to a new golden age.
Considering the video we just saw, that'd be the reason why this politician proposes bombing La Palma volcano as eruptions enter 30th day. Interesting, isn't it? La Palma volcano panic as Canary Island chief proposes dropping bombs to curb lava flows. Interesting, isn't it? I believe that the Father has determined that a tsunami will hit the symbol of Babylon, New York. And I believe the elite know it because they know the Bible. Of course, they want to make it seem as though they are the ones creating this, but it's not. Ultimately, the Father is in control and everything is in His Word. I believe this is one of the first calamities that will hit Babylon, USA, and weaken her. So, for those who do not know the Lord Jesus Christ, you see, once before 2,000 years ago, he came as a gentle sacrificial lamb to pay for our sins. When he returns in the near future, he is coming with great wrath and anger as a terrible, fierce judge to judge the earth. So please, make peace with him now. He is coming, and he is angry. And how do we make peace with him? Well, it's as easy as ABC. Admit that you're a sinner. Romans 3 verse 22 tells us, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And Romans 6 23 tells us, the wages of sin is death. B is to believe that Jesus paid for your sin at the cross. Romans 5 verse 8. But God demonstrates his love for us. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 6 verse 23. But the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, as opposed to death, the wages of sin. C. Confess that Jesus is the Son of God and commit your life to him. Romans 10 verse 9. That if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved and become part of the bride of Christ. Thank you for watching this video. Please, once again, like, share, subscribe. I remain your watchman, standing on the wall, blowing the horn as loudly as I can. I'm out.